Everyone, it's 12:53 and you're watching CT Style. TheaterWorks in Hartford is celebrating its 34th season of producing high-quality professional theater right here in Connecticut, and their latest production, Every Brilliant Thing, is set to debut next week. Joining us is director Eric Ort and actor Chad Jennings from Broadway's Wicked fame, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Nice to have you both here.
It's great to be
here. Great to be here.
All right, so set the story up for us, will you?
Okay, well, so the story begins with an adult telling us the story of his 7-year-old self who, in an effort to cheer up his sad mother, starts a list of all the things that make life worth living.
Aww.
And what we discover in the course of his storytelling is that as he matures, that list becomes a lifeline for him, and it helps him find love, it makes connections to friends, it strengthens his relationship with his father, and ultimately becomes this tool for really focusing on living.
Yeah, I think we all need that reminder every once in a while of the good things in life, right?
Sure.
Yeah. Chad, what's how have the rehearsals been going?
They've been really good. One thing that's very interesting is that the way this show, I'll call it a show, it's almost like a conversation between me and the audience. And what's different about this is that there's a little bit of give and take with the audience.
Oh.
And so in the course of the rehearsals, we've had groups of people come in so that I can
practice
work with
a little,
it. Exactly.
So you really don't know what you're going to get.
Yeah. I mean, I just have some loose rails to follow, but then it can go a lot of different ways. It's really fun.
Now, this is a little bit different than Broadway, kind of a smaller theater, would you say?
A little bit more intimate, yeah.
A little bit smaller, intimate, but that adds to the charm, doesn't it?
Absolutely. I'm very shy in...
I don't know if I believe that.
Oh, it's very true. And so in this very welcoming space that that TheaterWorks has, mm-hmm. It's really warm, comfortable, and... I promise that I'm trying to feel comfortable, and I'm going to make you feel comfortable if you come see the show, that sort of thing.
That's terrific.
And the intimacy, the show couldn't be done in a big space.
Right?
No,
yeah.
And because it really, truly is, it's this conversation between somebody who has some lessons that they want to share, these really lovely life-affirming lessons, and everyone who's in the room.
Sure.
And when we've done it with people in the room, there's an energy that lifts it up that is the show. That
sure.
is the show.
And that's kind of what you want people to take away from it, like this great feeling after seeing it?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's so smart and mm-hmm. funny, and you come into the space and you're going to be immediately enveloped by this warmth, which we can count on Chad's for.
Warmth.
I mean, warm and confident and funny, and it's this beautiful story.
That's great. Is this a one-man show?
Mm-hmm.
It's just you, huh? That's a lot of pressure to deliver.
There's a bit, yeah.
But that's fantastic. And you guys are located right in Hartford. You've been doing this for 35 years. What do you think the staying power is? Why do people keep coming back?
Well, I think it's because we tell these kinds of stories.
Yeah.
And they aren't all as positive and affirming as this show happens to be.
Mm-hmm.
And they aren't all as funny as this show happens to be. But they're all, there's a kind of core humanity to everything we do. And because it's in this really intimate setting, people live through the stories so much more connected.
Makes sense.
Yeah, it's really terrific.
And I know on the 18th, you guys are going to be holding a post-show reception. If people want to have the opportunity to chat with you both, like I'm doing right now,
yes,
that'll be fun.
Very
get your
special
tickets for
evening.
That.
Yes, yes. You have to pay a premium to actually spend time with us.
I would understand that. Chad, do you have any pre-show rituals that you do?
Oh, rituals.
Or how do you prep yourself for the day of the performance?
For this one, I'm going to spend some time in the house talking to people before
the show starts.
Get up and get moving, drink some water, say my mama la papalas to get the mouth working.
The mouth moving?
Yep. That's kind of it.
And you tell us a little bit about your stay on Broadway in Wicked.
Oh, it's fantastic.
Yeah.
I love the show. 3.5 years of... putting a goat head on my head and having to act with gloves like this as
a
goat.
It's a tough character to come across.
Yeah, a lot of like,
you've perfected the goat sound.
I've done it a bit.
You have, and then you went on the national tour.
Mm-hmm.
So you've been all over the country performing.
All over the country. It's been great.
And what do you think about Hartford, Connecticut?
Love it. It's the third time I've been here was here with Warhorse and South Pacific. And it's nice to be here for more than just like a week.
Yeah, there's good things here in the
Absolutely.
Capital City. And so how do we get our tickets for the show? There's still a few available?
There are still a few available. And one of, well, first of all, yes. business first, twhartford.org.
Okay.
twhartford.org. And we do have lots of seats available because people who are familiar with our theater will see that we're doing it in the round. So we actually have about 30 extra seats for each show.
Okay.
And it's seating that people who've been there before don't get a chance to see very often.
Fantastic.
Yeah, it's really exciting in that respect, too.
All right, so log on, get your tickets. It starts next week.
Mm-hmm. Next week.
Are you ready? Was that a goat sound?
Yes, I'm ready.
You're ready. It's going to be terrific. Thank you both for being here and for putting the show on. And thank you at all at home for watching. Again, that website for your tickets, twhartford.org. Every brilliant thing runs March 12th through the 22nd. Thanks for watching, everybody. Bye-bye.